Oh, goody.
All right, what's up, everybody? Zombies here again. And today, we're back with another Mercenaries video. Today, we're going to be covering the fourth Yashiraj event task. This one is Fight Fire with Fire, and it involves completing the N'Zoth bounty with N'Zoth in your party. For doing so, you will be rewarded with some Yashiraj coins as well as some N'Zoth coins. So we're going to take a look at the comp that I use for this, but I do just want to say a little something about this event task in particular. I personally am not a fan of them doing something like this. I really strongly dislike the fact that essentially one of the tasks for this event is locked behind a prior event. And yes, you can get N'Zoth in packs now. Yes, you can farm his coins and craft him, so it's not totally unobtainable. But especially if you're a newer player who is just recently starting, this one is significantly harder, and you have a relatively limited time frame, as we can see, ends in 7 days, to actually get enough N'Zoth coins to craft N'Zoth or get lucky in a pack or whatever it is. So yeah, I don't like something like this. It's cool thematically. I get why they did it thematically. Old gods beating N'Zoth with N'Zoth in the party, kind of cool. But in terms of player accessibility, I do not think this is the type of thing I would like to see more of going forward. It's just, it makes it a lot harder for newer players to do the whole event chain. And I do understand that a lot of these later on ones are geared a little bit more towards established players, but the new events bring in a lot of new players, and I think there should be a little bit better of a middle ground for making it accessible for them. And this is the first time we've seen an event where it really puts a significant barricade that isn't really a challenge, because it's not like you're trying to do something necessarily hard. It's purely, do I have this character or do I not have this character? And I don't really like that. So I did just want to mention that because, I just think that this is not something they should do in the future. But moving on, we're going to take a look at the comp for this one. We don't have to do this on heroic, so it should be pretty easy. Most of the new bounties on normal are pretty easy. We are going to be using the fire comp for this one, as always, but to be honest, you could probably get away with this with almost any comp that is halfway decent at PvE, so don't feel like you need the fire comp. It's just what I have, it's the fastest, so that's what I'm going to be using. So we have Belinda with her lesser water elemental, Rag with the fire damage, and Geddon with the Mark of Conflagration for the AoE damage, running Cookie to give them a little bit more HP so that they don't die on the way up to some random nonsense or some doppelgangsters. And then obviously you do need N'Zoth in your party here to get credit for this one. Again, not really that happy about that, but it is what it is. And we just have Chi-Gi as a backup fire unit. So pretty simple stuff. Again, I don't recall the N'Zoth bounty being that hard, especially on normal. So you could probably get this done with a lot of different and more budget-friendly comps if you are missing fire, but I know a lot of people at this point will have fire because it is the best comp for most of the PvE experience, so that's what I recommend using if you have it. So we're going to dive right on into the bounty. Before we do, if you enjoy this type of content, do remember to like and subscribe. There's a ton to help out the channel and keeps the Mercenaries videos coming. So without further ado, let's get into the bounty. All right, we have made it to N'Zoth here. So it's immune while his summon is active. At the start of each turn, he is going to summon some tentacles. So we need to kill the Psychus here as fast as possible. So we're just going to opt to go with our double blues here. And then probably just Rag for the fire damage. We don't really care if Rag dies because then we get a Belinda swap in. But again, this is normal. It shouldn't be overly difficult. I guess it makes more sense just to go for the targeted damage because I think the Die Insect can still hit the immune like it does with Jaina in PvP. So they swing with the summons, but Geddon will clean those up very nicely. Yeah, our fire damage just absolutely roasts them here. They do force our characters to attack each other, but we're using fire, so it's really not that big of a deal. So we're just going to continue to burn them down. We can even get some healing here with Chi-Gi. Chi-Gi just so good in the fire comp. Really a great addition for PvE. Get our AoE, get our heals, some more damage, and we should be able to take him down in another turn or two here. Oh, looks like they're benching us, but that's A-okay. We can't play them, but really doesn't matter. They give us a free Belinda swap, which should be more than enough to take him down pretty easily. Especially with the ice elemental stopping him from doing anything this turn. Just do a summon for N'Zoth. Might as well just increase our fire damage. I guess we could have even done frost damage. Doesn't really matter that we were doing fire because our fire units are benched. And we'll just freeze him again. Let's see, I guess we can steal N'Zoth's summon for funsies. Oh no, it dies. But we'll steal one of the other summons, so it's fine. Oh, they do kill our water elemental. A little unfortunate, but really doesn't matter that much. We get the steal, and now they return us again, but again, we really don't care. So yeah, this fight really not too bad. Again, the hardest thing about this is just having the legendary N'Zoth mercenary, which is kind of silly. So we'll just clean it up. A little blast from Rag, and that should do it. Oh yeah, I forgot they have the summons. I guess I should have used the Geddon AoE, but it's fine. Not a big deal. Still very easy clear here. Yeah, fire OP. And we got some useful coins out of it, too. You love to see it. I require another sacrifice. So that is going to be it for Event 4 of the Yashiraj event chain here. Fight with Fire, and we're going to get some nice Yashiraj and N'Zoth coins for it. So that's going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, do remember to like and subscribe. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.